Are you tired of watching the same boring walkthrough animations? Me too. Let's fix this today. Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. If you are new here, my name is Aka and I'm a CG artist. And on this channel, we explore techniques and tools that will help you become a better artist. Today, I will teach you the technique used in videography and animations called speedrumping. But first, let's start from a bit of a theory. But before we start though, make sure you subscribe to the channel if you aren't already, so you won't miss any future tutorials. You may ask me, Aga, how it works? Look at this graph. Horizontally, we have a time, and vertically, we have a speed. Dashed line shows the cuts between the two shots. Now, let me show you the clips. The camera movement is much faster close to the cut and at the end of the second clip. There are some variations using this technique, for example, to have a fast shot and slow it down close to cut. The transition is smooth and seamless using this technique. Also, it's really interesting and it can make your animation more dynamic. Hope it makes sense now. This technique is often used in real-life videography. So let me show you how to do it with the real-life footage, and then we'll jump to 3ds Max. In real life, this effect is usually achieved by recording everything in the higher frame rate and then slowing it down in post-production. Here I have two clips from my trip to Cuba recorded in 120 frames per second. I will start by cutting the clip in the right places. Take a look. Now it looks better, but it's way too fast. To create speed ramping effect, right click on the footage and choose show clip keyframes, then time ramping and speed. I do the same for the other clip as well. Next step is to add a keyframe. To do so, I click P on the keyboard. Then I click V and slow down the first part of the clip to 20%. Because 24 frames is 20% of 120. Then, I will do the same for the other clip, but this time I will make the end slower. It's not finished yet. We have to smooth it out. By using V tool, we can make a transition longer. Also, if we click here, we can smooth it by using a bezier curve. I will make the same with the other clip. And that's the effect, way better than on the beginning. If you like this content so far, please like and share this video, it will help me a lot. Now let's jump to 3ds Max. Doing it in 3D is easier, plus rendering high frame wouldn't be a good idea because it would add an extra rendering time. Motion blur is really important when doing speed ramping. The effect would look very strange without it. If you don't want to use it to save some time on rendering, I suggest you render the slow part without motion blur and add it to the last frames where the effect is really visible. I also added a bit of depth of field as usual. After you have the camera set, let's turn on the auto key option. Move the slider to the end of the timeline and move the camera to the place before the speed ramping. Then, go to the end of the animation and move the camera much more to create fast movement. When you are more or less happy with the result, open the curve editor. Change the point time to Bezier. Adjust the points so they are slow on the beginning and really fast on the end. We can adjust the path of the movement. To do so, go to Motion and choose Motion Paths. Now you can see the movement in the viewport. You are able to select the points and adjust them easily. We have to be careful as it affects the speed too. I will go back to the curve editor and make final adjustments here. I want the first part of the movement to be more constant. Looks great! If you want to go to the next level and learn how to create outstanding animations, you may be interested in our animation course. Click here to check it out on our website. Also, if you like this topic, you will love this custom playlist I created for you that has all of my videos about animations. Check it out! Bye bye!